What is the best computer for music production? In this video, I'll take a look at the components that you want to have in your best computer for music production, and I'll answer the most asked questions in my videos about computers for music production. Amongst there, the question, should I get a desktop or a laptop? In this video, I'll talk about the specifications for a new computer with the vision of buying the best computer for music production you can get. So not the budget or the mid-range category, but the I'm nearly a professional music producer category. I will put a table of contents in the description below. A laptop or a desktop? Well, a laptop is small and handy. That's it. But for music production, it's the worst machine you can get. A laptop is generally less powerful, and also you run quicker into overheating issues because your laptop can't get properly rid of the heat it produces under a heavy workload of music production. But also you can't expand as much with a laptop. Manufacturers of laptops tend to do concessions in speed in order to fit all the components in that small space of a laptop. For example, they choose a 4500 RPM hard drive instead of 7200, so a slower hard drive. They tend to do the same thing for the motherboard speed and memory speed. So if you absolutely need to produce on the road, yeah, choose a laptop. But in any other case, please do yourself a favor and choose a desktop. If you're working on the battery of your laptop, then your operating system, Windows or Mac, will slow down the computer to save the battery life of your computer, but that means that you don't have the optimal performance you can get from the machine. Yeah, I know you can change some settings, but a lot of people don't. So that's something to bear in mind. Mac or PC? Well, it may come as a shock to you, but music sounds the same on both platforms. All major DAWs have versions for both Mac and PC, the same for sound cards, but okay, there are some exceptions here and there. It comes all down to personal preference. For me, personally, I'm not an Apple fan anymore. I had some troubles with their hardware, but also I don't like their decisions regarding to soldering everything to your motherboard so you can't exchange it, your hard disk or your SSD in this case, or your memory. That means that if your SSD freezes up after 5 years, you can't exchange it. Your whole computer is dead. There is also a security chip in the newer Macs. The problem with that chip is that it makes macOS crash. That was first detected in and yet it's still not fixed by Apple. If you still want a Mac, you can choose a Mac desktop, an iMac desktop, or an iMac mini. I wouldn't go for the Mac Pro, that's the Mac Pro before 2019. You could choose for the Mac Pro, that's the desktop case, from 2019. Maybe an overkill, but hey, it works. I would at least avoid the MacBook Pros from 2015 to 2019. Because those have overheating issues, those have keyboard issues, and those have exploding issues in planes. I won't go into further details here. Check out my video Mac versus PC, check out my video Mac sucks, or my video about the Mac Pro. Links to those videos are, of course, in the description. What is important? In the early days, the most important things were processor and memory, but nowadays it's more SSD and the processor. And yeah, memory is important, it's still important, but it's not that important anymore. To be honest, an SSD doesn't let you make your music faster, but your computer feels much more responsive and more snappier. The processor. A 7 series processor of the latest generation, with preferably as much cores as possible. As you may know, synthesizer plugins, reverb plugins, and analyzer plugins will take up a big chunk of CPU power. So you need a pretty powerful processor. It's the most important thing for music production.
The quicker the CPU, the more calculations it can do in a second without having any dropouts or that annoying message in logic. With CPUs, the number of gigahertz is important. Rule of thumb, the higher the better. Because we have limitations in the number of gigahertz a processor can produce, we increase the processing power by adding more cores. A core is effectively another processor in the same shell that is working side by side by the other processors. So more cores is more speed. But with double the cores, you don't have double the speed. With four cores, you have a good basis for music production.
Yay!
There are roughly five types of CPUs. In order of processing power in the same generation, the first being the slowest and the last being the quickest. The 3 series, then the 5 series, and quicker are the 7 series. Some brands have even a more powerful 9 series and server grade processors. Server grade processors tend to have more cache memory, which makes them quicker. But the server processors are somewhat behind in development, sometimes one or more generations. And is the price increase worth the extra speed? Well, most of the time not.
What is cache memory? Cache memory is also important for speed. Cache memory of a processor is the fastest memory there is. If a processor can find repeated tasks in the cache memory, it doesn't have to go to the slower RAM memory. In other words, the bigger the cache of a processor, the quicker the CPU.
Oh, and one thing. Those turbo boost frequencies are more a marketing term than anything else. With turbo boost, you can boost your frequency for a short amount of time, and that is useful for opening a website, for example, but not for music production. You don't take advantage of that. You ask a constant amount of computing power of your processor. AMD or Intel? Well, that's an excellent question. At the moment, AMD is king when it comes to speed. However, AMD makes an implementation of an Intel processor instruction set. But I have to say, the compatibility improved tremendously over the last few years. But I heard rumors of some MIDI controllers not working and some plugins not working. So I asked producers specifically which plugins and which MIDI controllers are not working, but I got no real answers. Thunderbolt on AMD is still a little bit problematic because it's Intel technology. Music producers seem to think that you always need a big amount of memory in your computer. Well, that's not always the case. If you use a lot of synthesizers, then you need a big CPU, but not a lot of memory. But when you use a lot of sample-based instruments, then you need a lot of memory, but not a lot of CPU power. 16 gigabytes is, well, the minimum for music production. You can get memory in different speeds. And of course, the faster, so more megahertz, is better than the slower. But yeah, it's just a small difference. Nevertheless, if you want to achieve a certain kind of speed, make sure that and your memory module supports it and your motherboard supports it. You can't easily exchange CPUs. You can easily exchange memory, except if you have an Apple. So if you are on a budget, choose a bigger CPU instead of a big chunk of memory. Storage. Choose a SSD drive. SSD stands for solid state drive, and solid state as opposed to the loose state of a spinning magnetic platter hard drive. Choose at least 1 terabyte. You will run out of space sooner or later. And especially sample-based plugins eat up a lot of space. For example, there is a widely commonly used sample-based plugin that already takes up 500 gigabytes full installation. And you need to have some room left for your operating system, so Windows or Mac, your DAW, your samples, and your projects.
You want to have a PCIe or M.2 connection on your SSD, because then the drive is directly inserted into the spine of your computer, which makes it quicker. The other connection is the old school SATA connection, which was made for those old school spinning magnetic platter drives. An SSD with SATA is still faster than a loose state hard drive, but when you have the choice, choose PCIe or M.2. PCIe or M.2 is 6 times faster in reading stuff and 3 times faster in writing stuff than SATA. A SSD drive has an extra advantage above the traditional hard drive. They are not likely to crash when bumping or sudden movements occur. That is especially handy for notebooks which have a portable character. The difference between PCIe and M.2 is the connection in the computer. The only difference being that M2 is meant for SSD and PCIe for various extensions like sound cards and graphics cards. If you have an M2 connection on your motherboard, choose M2, because then you have more free slots for other hardware.
An SSD is quicker than a hard drive, but a hard drive is cheaper per gigabyte. There are hybrid solutions out there, so you can take advantage of both, but you can also choose to have both types of drives in your computer. Then you can put your DAW, your samples and your operating system on your SSD for the quick parts and do a project, for example, on your hard disk for the slower parts. A good quality big wide screen, preferably a 21 inch screen, well, better even a 27 inch screen, and well, preferably even more than that, a big wide screen, because if you can see more of your timeline, you have to scroll less, which means a quicker workflow, which means that you can produce your music faster. There are ultra wide screens on the market, and those are ideal for music production and video editing. You can also choose a second screen, then you can put your tracks on your first screen and the EQ and mixer, for example, on your second screen. A graphics card, and surprisingly, a graphics card doesn't matter that much. DAWs don't take advantage of the extra computing power like in video editing, for example. Don't get me wrong, you need a graphics card in order to get a picture on your screen, but an onboard graphics card will do the job just fine. A mouse. Often in music production, you also need to scroll sideways, and it's really handy to have a mouse that supports horizontal or side scrolling. Side scrolling means a quick workflow, which means that you can work faster.
The frequently asked questions.
Question number one. I have computer X. Does it work? Yes, probably every computer will run DAW software. But there are computers that are just faster than others. Some components might result in some latency issues, but that's only in rare cases and I wouldn't worry about it too much. With laptops though, you have to be more careful. I go into specifics for the best laptops for music production in another video. Check out the link in the description. Can I use my old computer for music production or do I have to buy a new one? If you have a Mac or Windows computer less than 10 years old, yeah, it will probably work. Just install free music making software that is called a DAW and see for yourself. That's 100% more accurate than any answer I can give you. What free music making software is best to use? I made a special video about it. The link is in the description below. 10th gen or 9th gen processor or 27th gen and 26th gen processor. What will be faster? Well, on the same amount of megahertz, a newer processor, a newer generation processor will be quicker than the previous one. Make sure you compare the same series against each other. So a 7 series with a 7 series instead of a 5 series and a 7 series CPU. Will DAW X work on computer Y?
I don't know.
Check the specs on the site of the software maker. You only recommend expensive computers. I'm not rich. Well, those are just the better computers for music production. Faster computers are just more convenient. Check out my free ebook because there I will go into more detail about computers and laptops for music production, also the budget and the mid-range category.
Here is a list of my recommendations. If you want to buy a laptop for music production, check out my special video about the subject here in the screen and also in the description below.